Hey, this is Christian Robinson Music, and I'm here with a quick lesson. This lesson has a couple of things going on, so it's a combined lesson of the number system, chords, and dealing with the 2-5-1, which is a turnaround. So this progression is labeled as a blues progression, but this progression can be used in a lot of different genres of music. So we're gonna do a G major progression, okay? So in the key of G major, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. So it's important to know the chord scale. So in this progression, it's gonna go as follows. So I'm gonna try to remember the chord progression using the bass only, right? So the progression starts off on the one. Then it's the one, but it's gonna be a dominant one, which is a dominant seven. Then it goes to the four. Then it's a flat five. Go back to the one. 6, 2, 5, 1, 4, 1, 5, okay? So it's a lot of movement, but once you get familiar with moving back and forth from the 1 to the 4 to the 5, it'll become simple. You will understand that it's just a basic blues turnaround, okay? But it's based off a 2-5-1. So let's look at the chords now. So that first chord is a G major, then it turns into a G7. So two measures, you'll do the G, one, then G flat seven, then you go to the four, which is C7. And then you go to the flat five, which is D flat diminished. Then we go to the one, sorry. So that's a half measure, one, then the E, right? Okay, so it's a half a measure, one, and then six. Right? So just practice going from that one, right? Because usually if it was a full measure, it would sound like this. But we're gonna cut that measure in half. One, right? One, six, right? So that's what I'm doing. One, six. Then the two is a dominant seven. Then the D seven, which is the five, then the one, then the four, which is C7, back to the one, and then the five. Okay, so again, starting on the one, that's G major, then C7, four, and then that diminished flat five, right? Then the one, then to that six, that quick six, then the two, which is dominant seven, then that D seven, then 1-4-1-5. And you can do moving. All right, so let me try to play it cleanly now without talking. I'm trying to do that diminished. Ooh-wee, quick E. I don't know if I said it, it was the E, that six is the E, E7, A7, D7, 1-4-1-5. Okay, let me try it again. 1, I'm going slow. Dominant 7, then the 4, which is the C, then the diminished flat 5, I keep changing the shape, but the shape is the same, going from the, 1, excuse me, going from the 1, I can keep this shape and just move it to the E, right? So it's that movement that I'm not used to making. So to the, I keep trying to make my shape be something else. So it's pretty simple. So then 2-5-1-4. Alright, so here we go. So what I did was G major for 2 measures, then G7 for 2 bars, and then go to the 4, which is C7. Then that diminished D flat. Then the 1 again. Half a measure, go to the E. The 2. Keep playing that 1 different. I keep playing the 1 like I want to play a C major 7, because that's what I was doing in the last song. All right, so anyway, so G major, G7, C7, C sharp diminished, then G, half a measure, go up to the E, my bad, 7, A7, D7, G, C7, G, D7. Okay, so that was pretty good for me to say it and play it at the same time. That's what's really holding me, you know, down, is trying to say the chord and play the chord on time at the same time. All right, so the chord progression, the chords, and the 2-5-1 is what I'm trying to show you, right? So, you know, I'm combining different chord shapes, at least 3 different chord shapes, right? We have the G major, which is just a major chord on the 6-string root. Then we have the C7 on the four string root, so that's a C7. That means that it has a flatted seven. Then you come back to, so then you go from there. Then we have that diminish with a fifth string root, right? So that's a C sharp or D flat diminished on the fifth string root, okay? And then we come back to the G major again on the sixth string root, half a measure. Then we go to the E7, still that fifth string root E7, dominant seven. It's really a minor chord, but it has a flat seven. Flat seven, flat three. Now we go to the minor seven. A7. So that's a A7. It's a minor, but it has the flatted seven. Then the D7, which is right above it. So the A7 is a six string root chord, and then the D is right above it, which is a fifth string root. That's a D7. Remember, you had the E7. You got a C7. You have an E7. You have the D7. They're all the same shape, right? And then you go back to your one, then C7, then G, then you finish up with your five, which is the D. So that's pretty much it. I only gave you three different shapes: a major, a seven, and that diminish. Okay, so learning just those three right there can get you a lot. You know, you got suspended, you have, you know, a flat two this, you got, you know, nine sharp this, and you got a whole bunch of other chords. But with those three different chord types, you can pull this off in a lot of other chord progressions. So hopefully this lesson has helped someone. All right, I'm out of here. Peace.